Hello, everyone. Welcome to A Moment in Time with Taylor. We're trying something totally different today. I have never ever scoped from an external webcam, an external microphone. So we're gonna see how this goes. You might still be able to hear my laptop fan because it's really loud and it goes pretty loud. It should be a lot better quality than my other microphone was though when I did my producer broadcasts. And it's gonna look a little different because the camera is so much higher than my computer screen and I can't make it any lower. So I'm doing my best here. Hello everyone, thanks for pouring in here. Hey Kiki, how are you? Golden girl, I love it. Hey Logan, hey Ryan. My Android is already failing me on showing any comments, so I think I might. Thank you for inviting Manny. And I'm gonna translate this Arabic using egg drop. Hello, marhaba. Okay, let me restart my Periscope. Oh, is it gonna? I don't know, this might crash. We'll see. I'll be back if it crashes. Are you still with me? Hello, Scott. Whoo, that's a big spider on the floor. Okay. Hey, Robert and Millsboro. Hello, 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 everyone. Am I still alive? Can you guys still see me? I can't see anything. Hey, Shiny. It looks like we're still going, right? Thanks for inviting Ryan. So we're gonna learn how to broadcast from your computer. I'm hoping that I can actually watch this on my phone so I don't have to leave this screen up. There I am. Okay. Perfect, Logan. Really? You speak six languages? That's amazing. It's saying I'm taking screenshots. Okay. That's weird. I'm watching this, but it's not. What if I watch it from the iPhone? Don't worry, we have like a million devices. We have a computer, we have an Android, we have an iPhone. Landscape mode. Yeah, I know. This is the only way I think I can film. Actually, I don't know if this. I'm just curious. I'm going to just try it. I'm just going to tilt this whole thing over. Does it switch into portrait if I do that? Curious. No, it just goes sideways. What's up with this view? This is my new camera. Now I'm knocking everything over. Mm-mm-mm. Okay, how are we? Hey Jay, it's a cyborg world. That's true, it is. I got devices everywhere. All right, okay. So what I'm doing right now is I'm broadcasting from my computer. I am using a feature of Periscope called Periscope Producer, and you can find all of the producer settings in your Periscope settings. So if you go into your settings, you'll see Periscope Producer as one of your settings. Hi, Trevor. And oh, the camera that I got is a C920. It's a Logitech C920, and it has the stereo microphone with the camera on it. See, it's way better. Look at this. I'm in front of a lit up window, which you would never normally sit in front of light like this. And I think I still look perfectly fine. And earlier in the day when it was so bright out there, it looked fine. It looked perfectly fine. It wasn't washing me out at all. I didn't look shadowy at all. Oh, Fly Girl, yes, Pilates. There's something called Pi-Yo where they combine Pilates and yoga that I've never done before, but it sounds pretty interesting. Yes, the quality is way better, way better. This broadcast is brought to you by Logitech C920. Yes, thank you for inviting Logan. Yes, that's awesome. Okay, so that's gonna be the first step. You wanna go find producer in your Periscope settings. Why don't I just show you right on my... You like eating pie? That's good. Hey, Dusty. Oh, thank you, Moby. And I'll show you. So if you're on an iPhone, oops. Here, let me just turn this off. I'll just be kind of dark. You still can't see it. Dang, the screen is way too bright. I can't really show you. You know what I can do? I can try something. I don't know if I really want to do this just right this second, but let me see. Oh, Pio. I'm glowing. I'm not glowing now. Now I'm in the dark, right? I'll put this back on. Hey, Dan. Hey. How do I get the camera looking normal like that? It looks like crap when you connect it. What kind of camera do you have, Amy? ASMR will be louder now. Yeah, but you know what? It doesn't do binaural. Like, it has a stereo mic, but if I come over... Does anyone have headphones in? Can someone tell me if you have headphones in? Or put headphones in and let me know. It looks bad when you do it, Amy? I literally just plugged it into the USB. I didn't do anything special with settings at all. I just plugged it in. Yolatis. You haven't had power for like 5 hours. Oh no, it's gonna kill your battery. I'm sorry, Moby. Headphones are in. Okay, Undertaker, will you just tell me if you can hear this in two different ears? Okay, so that's one side. Danique said that it sounds exactly the same no matter which side I do it on. It is binaural? Really? It worked? Okay, thanks, Moby. Have a good day. You hear in both just the same, yeah. Dusty claims to hear it binaurally, but Danique said the same thing. She said she heard it exactly the same on both sides. Hey, Alex, how are you? Both ears, yeah. You're partially deaf on the left side. Hey, Gregifer, how are you? And thank you, Jeff, for the feedback. Someone get that mosquito. It's going good, Alex. It's going good. I'm excited to teach you guys how to use this. So you're going to want to go in your settings, and you're going to find Periscope Producer in your settings. And it will have your recommended settings right in there, but if you have any problems at all, I'm going to go away now, okay? You're going to see something else come in my place. So I will be back. Don't worry. So here, if you just Google how to set up Periscope Producer, you'll come to this page, periscope.tv/help/external encoders, okay? It's called the Producer Broadcasting Guide. It's gonna look like this when you first populate it. Scroll down to page two, and right here you have starting a producer broadcast. This is as zoomed in as I can get it, so I hope that you can see it pretty well. And this will tell you exactly how to set this up. So the first thing that you're going to want to do is set up an encoder, such as OBS. So OBS is what I use, and that's just the name of the program that you have to download. Dan. Yes, it can screen grab, exactly. You just got home from work, Alex? Nice. Welcome home. Welcome home. You're going to learn some stuff today if you want. You're going to learn today. Just kidding. Okay. So what I'm gonna do now, it's gonna freak you out, okay? Just gonna put it out there. It's gonna freak you out. It's gonna be crazy. It's gonna look crazy, but it's gonna show you what my screen looks like. Let me just make sure I don't have anything private up. No, I don't. Okay. So you're gonna see my screen here. I'm gonna go away again. It's gonna look really crazy. You're gonna see my screen, and you're gonna see what it looks like to be in OBS, okay? Get ready. Okay. So there we are. Sorry, I just have to read your comments this way. The mic sounds blown out. Really? If I talk too loud, really? That's crazy. It's so far away from me. Hey, Zeke. Hello, Swede. I can't talk quieter. I'm so used to having really crappy microphones. Open freak out. Regard. You're an egg. You're not a bot. Are you pretending to be a bot? Okay, dropping the knowledge. Yes. Thank you, Alex. Stop that, Dan. You're gonna get blocked. You love to learn? Yes, teaching you egg drop. Yes. So this is what I'm looking at right now is egg drop. This is, oh, it's kind of cut off on the side there, isn't it? Ah, you get the idea. It's just cutting off your faces. So this is how I go back and I look at all the old comments. I can go all the way back to the very beginning, first comment of the broadcast, which I think was Kiki. What the heck? Why is there so much empty space at the bottom of this page? Am I like not clicked into this? That's weird. Page up. That was weird. It's like so much empty grayness on the bottom. Okay. So the first comment was Kiki. Hey, Golden Girl. And I can go all the way back and I can search all these comments. So if I wanted to do Control F and I wanted to see, okay, what did James say? I can look up. Oops, sorry, if I could actually spell it. I could look it up by his name and just look at his comments and go through and find, like, if he's like, hey, you missed my comment, you know, that's how I go back and look. So that's just a quick little sneak peek into Egg Drop. What did the fox say? Hey, cat, hello. You missed Harry in here yesterday. He actually made it to all the way to the end of a broadcast. We unfollowed each other. Elusive, what? How can I even follow you? I can't click anyone on here. What image? I don't want your image. I want your page. Here we go. We're gonna follow you live. We're following Chad live on Scope. What is this? Can I follow him like this? I don't know if I can follow him from here. I can do it like this though. Boom. No? No. I don't know how. I don't think I can add someone like this. Oh, what if I just use Periscope? Boom. It's happening. It's happening. Following. Boom. Done. Next question. And Mr. Comment. Yeah, there you go. You're proud of Harry? Me too, Kat. I was very proud. All right. On egg drop. I can't wait to do my first scope. Yes, Dan, yes. And this, okay, so you can see too how I could show you guys, like if I wanted to share videos or music, I could just pull up whatever I wanted on my screen and share it with you guys. And if I wanted to, I could feed the audio through the computer for that instead of using the mic that I'm using now, but you get the idea. Bug Life, what? Yes. That's actually, Hattricks is actually someone who also works at Periscope, so check them out on SoundCloud. And okay, so back to OBS. Up here, you'll see OBS 19.0.3. That's the version. I don't know if it's the most updated version, but it probably is. So you just want to download OBS. So you're just gonna go out right over to Google, and you're just gonna go download OBS. Now, if you already use something for streaming, maybe you use Twitch or some other type of gaming streaming that you do, you can use that encoder. If you already have an encoder, just use that. But I don't really know much about encoders. I just know I use OBS. It's the most common one that I've heard of, and it's free. So Open Broadcaster Software, it's obsproject.com/download, and you'll just click that, and you will be able to get it. Once you have it, you're going to be ending up in a screen like this, except it will be black. It will just be the same size rectangle here, this whole rectangle, this whole thing, but it's just going to be black. And all of this won't be here. There will be no sources. And this is exactly how you create your producer broadcasts. You just add in sources as you want them. So you can see this color source, if I move it to the top, is that rectangle that I use. And you can change that into any color. If you double click on color source, you can change the color to anything that you want. Same thing goes with the text that I use. So if I move the text to the top so you can actually see it, I can double click into the text and I can change the color here by selecting color. And I can change the font rate or the text right here, change whatever I want to write, type, 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 change it, and select the font size, bold, underline, strike out, all that stuff. And then okay. And then you can drag and drop to adjust sizes like that. It's very, very user-friendly, I would say. It's a little bit off center now. I don't know. You could be really picky about it if you want, or you could just do what I do. Okay, so now I'm going to quickly go back into. Well, here, instead of making you watch your own comments, why don't I turn off this and come back? Ooh, look at that hair. Okay, this needs to be angled down just a bit. Okay. And what are you guys saying? Oh, thank you, EJ. I won't block you. Thank you for inviting. Look at my new camera. It's so good. This is the same camera that EJ uses. So make sure you follow EJ Luna Official. He is going to help me if I have any problems with this. Right? It's sharp, right? I know. Now you can see like how crazy my hair actually looks. More light. How's that? I do have a ring light. That's exactly what I just cranked up on me. But now that's too much light. That's too much light. You mean more light in the room? Okay, stand by. How's that? That too loud? Good. Yay! That was a fun test. Woke you all up, right? Yay! Clap on, clap off? No, it's not clap light. Your camera seems to be 4:3 aspect ratio, is that intended? No, I think that's just what it defaulted to because I just plugged it in and started this. Thank you, Undertaker. Name same, how are you? Hang on, I missed everything before EJ came in. Thank you, Dan. You're good too. Drag and drop, what's that? This is how you do it. This is exactly how I do it. Hola, Lorenzo. Que tal? I'm a You are a scopes all pro. Thank you, Robert. The spider is coming for me. The spider is coming for me. Okay. Lights on, lights off, the clapper. Yes, the clapper. No, it's not the clapper. Hello, iDesign. How are you? How are you? How are you? Okay. So let me show you what each. I showed you color and text. Now I'm gonna come back. I'm gonna go away. You're gonna see my crazy display again. Don't freak out, okay? Don't freak out. Take a deep breath. Boom. Okay, so we went over the text, we went over the color. And you know these little eyeballs right here? You can hide anything you want to hide. So if I wanted to hide the text, if I wanted to hide the color, I would just click the eyeball and then I can have it pop back up anytime that I want it. Right now, what you're seeing is display capture, and that literally just captures your entire screen. I can crop it if I want to, but that's how I'm going to get a complete screen share. Window capture is what I'm using to show you guys the Periscope producer outline. So I have to hide the display to show you. So I just unhid window capture because it's underneath display capture. I just have to hide that. And then you'll see that that's the window capture. I'm capturing the Opera browser. You would use Chrome or Safari, whatever it is. You would just capture that window and then you could share that web page if you wanted to. And that's what I'm using to show you how to set this up. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Let me bring this back. And then I also have my video capture device, which is just my camera. So to add a new source, you press add, this little plus sign down under sources, and click what you want to add. Is it an image? Is it text? Is it a video? Is it a window capture? Color? Display capture? You can use some of these other things. I mean, image is exactly what it sounds like. It's just photos. You can also create a slideshow of images. And that's what I used for that close-up. Yeah, let me just hide my display really quick and I can try to pull that up to give you an example. Hello, I want this back. Boom, boom. Okay. Stand by. Image slideshow. Okay. Oh, but I have to grab each file individually? No, I don't think I did that, did I? I might have. No, I added a directory, I think. Let's see. I just don't want you guys to see all the stuff in my computer. Trivia, close-up images, select folder. Let's try that. There we go. Okay. Now I'm just going to fit it to my screen. There we go. And then you can see the images on a slideshow. I don't think I actually used a slideshow because you can't, I don't know. You can't like stop the slideshow, I don't think. Let's see. Is EJ still here? If you play something with audio on your laptop, will it grab from the mic or play directly to the feed? You can change it. You can pick whatever mic you want. It will automatically grab your laptop mic, but when I plugged this camera in, it automatically overrode the mic to be the mic on the camera. But it did not automatically override the camera. Hi, Luigi. How are you? Cinnamon roasted almonds, yes. Intel Core i5 or higher. Is that true? I don't know, Ryan. Mine is an i5, so I don't actually know. Mine's an Intel, but I'm really not sure. It could be. It could be. Almonds are yummy. They are. Your connection's really bad. Aw, freak out. You wish I had a Mac? How come? Are you getting a special mic for ASMR? I got this mic thinking it would work for ASMR, but it's not really binaural, so I'm gonna put the 3DO mic on my wish list, on my Amazon wish list. You're good on my last night shift. At least get some sleep after night. Good. The clapper was like the 80s version of the echo, right? Oh, okay. All right, EJ already left. Okay. Drag and drop. Oh, nice. Drag and drop. Yes. That's great. The last picture was creepy. I couldn't guess it. FemYoga getting flash level effects. Yes. Working on it. My day was good, Zane. How was yours? The new cam and mic seem to be working really well. I totally agree. Is this also how others broadcast their tips? Or sponsorships credits. Yes, iDesign, that is a great point. Yeah, let me show you how I could do that. How does this work? Wait, this is a battery belt? How does this work? Wait, what? This is a battery belt? How does what work? I can't even find where you're changing the colors. My Mac looks different. Okay, you know what? You probably need to update your OBS because if you have an old version of OBS, there wasn't any choice for color source. And if you want anybody in here, especially if I know you, like Shiny, we could do a video call if you want and I can look at your screen. And even if you want, we could do that right now and everyone could watch and learn with us. Totally up to you. So this is just scrolling through a selection of images that I have. And what I could do, and I think what I actually did was I put every single image in. Oh no, that's what I did. Okay, I'll show you what I did. I'll show you what I did. I forgot. I forgot it. All right, let me bring my display back. So I'm gonna take this slideshow, and this is how you remove a source. So I'm just gonna click remove, and that's gonna completely delete it. Not just hide it, but now it's gone. And then what I did with that, here, let me hide my display again really quick so I can pull this up. I did something new with my eye makeup today too. Do you like it? It's kind of like a fade, darker on the outside, lighter on the inside. And then I tried to do wings. They're not even with each other, but I'll figure it out one day. So those images are in my Periscope folder under trivia, close-up images. Okay, and then what I did is I opened one. All right, cool. So here is what I did. I'm gonna show you my display again. Oh, my hair. My hair! All right, display. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna. What I did, okay, so I went to my images and I opened it up. So again, this is Windows, but I'm sure Mac is very similar. This is Windows Photo Viewer, whatever it opens in. When you open it on a Mac, that's what you're gonna try to capture in your OBS. So you go into OBS, you click Add New Source, and you're gonna click Window Capture. You're gonna use Window Capture a lot. Personally, I use it a lot. So Window Capture, you can name it something if you want, like you could call it Close Up Images. Because that's what this was the game that we were playing when I did this. And then I'm gonna grab that window. So you can see I can grab other, well, it's not really showing you any other options for some reason, but you can normally grab like any window that you have open. So you can see that it populated it in kind of a weird size. So what I'm going to do now, I'm not sure how much of my mouse you're seeing now because this is on top. But what I'm gonna do, let me try to right click really close to the edge. If I right click on the image, you can also right click on the source that you want to use. So if you want to right click right on Window Capture, you could do that. Where is it? Oh, Close Up Images, sorry. Right click on Close Up Images. And then you would hover over Transform. And Transform is what you use when you wanna change the size or like you can flip it side, like left or right or up and down. You can rotate it. So that's what Transform is. So I'm gonna do Transform and I'm just gonna click Fit to Screen. And then it's automatically gonna do that work for me. And if I feel like the other stuff doesn't look good in the background there, I could remove them. But I need to first crop this image. So I'm not sure if the display capture, I feel like, can I move this to the top? Is that gonna mess with me? Kind of. I'm not sure how well you're gonna be able to see me actually doing this. Here, I'll demonstrate it on here. So if I right click the box that I want to change the size of, I'm gonna click transform, or I'm gonna hover over transform, and I'm going to click edit transform. And then here, hopefully that's all in the range where you can see it, I'm going to change the sizes. So I can cut off the top, the bottom, the right, the left, however much I want. And this is in number of pixels. So say I didn't want this top part, this is OBS 19.0.3 showing, I could just click into the top box and just use my up arrow key and just start cropping away any pieces that I don't want. So that is what you're gonna see me do now, and I'm gonna reset that. And that's what you're gonna see me do now on the other one, although you might not be able to see what I'm actually clicking just because I'm moving it to the top, so the display is kind of getting tinkered with. So I'm right clicking, I'm hovering over transform, I'm clicking edit transform. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna crop off the top and I'm gonna crop off the bottom. Your choice if you want to crop off the sides. I'm going to leave it for now. And then I could hide anything else that looked kind of funky. Maybe I want to move this image up. Oh, that's not what I wanted to move. How do I grab it? Let's see. Close-up images. Okay. Can I move you now? Yeah, so if I wanted to move it like that or something, however you think looks good on your channel. And then what I do, let me go back to display. If I don't know how much of this you can see, hopefully you can see some of it. Then what I do to scroll through the images is I actually go into my photo viewer and then I just click to the next image. And then they'll see that on their screen. They won't see this weird little display capture thing in the back. That's just because I'm trying to show you the behind the scenes version. So all they're gonna see is gonna look real professional like. It's just gonna be you clicking through. You can say, what's this? And somebody guesses, yeah, it's the bottom of an apple. Next question, what's this? Yeah, it's a ball. Okay, what's this? It's a balloon. And you just play a game like that, or however you wanna do it, whatever's fun for you. Whoa, what is this? Why is my screen all freaking out? Stop freaking out. What the heck? Is it just like cut off big white block? What is that? What is this white block? That was weird. Oh, you know what? It's because I closed that box. That's why. And now it's just a black screen. Hello, I'm back. All right. I'm gonna go back to the comments. I'm sure there are a lot of questions. Could be poses in yoga instructional. Yeah, I could show images of poses. I could show videos if I wanted to. Make sure that you're only showing things that you have the right to show. You have to own the rights to it, or it's royalty free or something like that. Thank you, Johnny. All right, let me go all the way down and catch this. You can also broadcast on Facebook with OBS. Okay, I didn't even know that. I don't really like Facebook Live at all. Mine went from bad to good. I'm so tired. Oh, well, I'm glad that it's good now, Zane. Hopefully, you can get some sleep if you need it. Flower, broccoli. Yes, cat got broccoli. You can also broadcast. Yeah, okay. Thought it was wasabi peas, mangoes. Screenshots are going from close to wide shots, guessing items. Yeah, yep, exactly. Carrot, carrot, celery. Yep, you guys are good. I thought this was Pictionary, pretty much. Hey, our game. Yes, rude. We're in a matrix. You look more white with this cam. Interesting. You look special today. Thank you, Luigi. It's my new camera. Thank you, Kat. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Someone is having fun with new toys. Yes. Please keep scope up. Oh, yes, Mike. You got it. I don't delete my scopes. You got it. I will leave it for you. Hey, Sean. Moo, Eric. Welcome, welcome, welcome. You thought they fixed the swipe? Oh, yeah, no. Transform. I don't know how to say an Optimus Prime voice. Transform. No, I don't know how to say it. Can you show how you chose the pick? Yes, I think I did show that, but I'll try to show it. It doesn't, when I do the display capture, once I start adding sources, it makes it hard to see things, but let me try. Okay, back to display capture. What I did is I clicked add. Well, hang on. First, I had to actually have it open. So I just grabbed, oh yeah. So basically, okay, so I went into wherever, you know what I mean? Like this was, I think I'd probably show you at least this much. And then I went into trivia, I went into my close-up images, and then I just grabbed an image. I literally just opened it on my computer. I just double-clicked it or whatever it is on a Mac. And then this is what I grab in OBS. So then I went to OBS, I clicked plus, I clicked window capture, and then I just grabbed that window. And then I cropped it. So first I took it, I right-clicked on window capture and transform, fit to screen. And then I right-clicked on window capture again, hovered over transform, clicked edit transform, and then cropped off the top, cropped off the bottom. And called it a day. I'm just gonna hide that now. I'm gonna hide the display, go back to comments. That almond looks brown sugar roasted. Yum. Optimus Prime Transformers. The pro content producer now. Such learning. Good. Yeah, I've actually done broadcasts like this in the past when I first started. I learned how to use Periscope Producer right in the beginning. I'm good, John. How are you? You can't play music. You can play other people's music, or if people give you the rights to play their music, like Hat Tricks. I asked him if it was okay to play his music on my scopes, and he works for Periscope, so he knows.
Real
And he said
soldiers don't turn soldiers,
yes. So this
you
is
broke
fine.
boys,
I
you
can
find
play this. I can
colors,
play my own
boy,
music.
you
I can play Never's music. I follow Never on here too. I think he's only got like one song on here, but still. People. That's not him. Wait, I'm already following Never. Here he is. And then play. Okay, get the idea. Is this some of what Flash uses too? Yes, indeed it is. It's a really good tutorial. Thank you, Alex. Son, you can collaborate with Periscoping musicians as well as cross promotion. Exactly. Yes. Music is gray area. It's like giving mixtapes. Yeah. So also, if anyone wants to demonstrate this, I don't know if anyone's feeling adventurous, but if you want to come on my broadcast right now, I could. Hang on, let me hide my display here. Oh wait, I'm not showing you display. You're just looking at me. I didn't know you could see me. Hi. Okay. What I want to do. Actually, before I do that, let's go back to what we were reading here in the guide. Oops, not that. Not that. This. I'm gonna get rid of that so I don't keep doing that. Okay. So here, from the settings area in the app, select advanced sources. Now, this is actually a little bit old because it automatically does this for you now, as far as I know. If you go into your Periscope settings and click on Periscope Producer, you used to have to click something that said like create new source, but I haven't had to do that. Maybe you do. If you don't see anything there that says like view broadcast or preview broadcast, you're just going to click create new source. And then you'll see something come up that has, it's going to say source connection info. It's going to give you a server URL. It's going to give you a stream key or stream name. And then you can, a source display name, which is optional, you can name it something if you want, as well as diagnostics. So it will tell you, Periscope settings will actually tell you if any of your settings are awry before you go live. So then you can double check, get it all sorted out before you actually go live. So that's pretty much what this says. You create a new source, configure your encoder, such as OBS, to point to the publishing point from step one. Configure the streaming settings with the exact specifications listed below. And what that means, the address of your stream is the stream key. So I'm going to show you my display again. Settings is down here for OBS. Click settings, and then it's going to be stream. And you have to make sure in the URL and the stream key matches what you're seeing in your Periscope settings. And this is exactly how we broadcast to other people's streams as well. So I can broadcast from my computer, my OBS, onto Joey's Eggdrop account because I have his stream key. So, and as long as I can like log into his Twitter account and all of that as well, you'd have to have their Periscope login so you could actually go live from Periscope. But this is how we use Producer on other people's streams. So you would just make sure that your stream key, your URL is good, and then all you'll have to worry about is these other settings like output, audio, video, general, all of that kind of stuff. You wanna see how nice the new camera looks? Hang on, I gotta get out of this part. Hang on, I wanna show off to my husband. Stand by. Stand by.
Are you doing an airdrop?
No, this is well, I am showing the mic drop, but this is my account, so I have free roam to do whatever and say whatever I want. Look how good you look.
Amazing. I
Amazing!
wish could have been sharp.
It looks really good, doesn't it? It's so much better. You should see. Look, actually, I can show you guys what the other camera looks like.
You can switch it.
You guys are gonna die when you see this. I guess it's not that bad, but like, look at the side by side. Oh my god, so bad.
Whoa.
You see that?
One looks red.
I know. I'm like, why am I so red? And then it turns out I'm not really red. It's just the camera, I think.
I want to see if these colors, what they're going to look like. Yeah, look at the difference in color. Completely different.
I feel like this one's more true, though. Like you're red. This other one made it look orange.
Yeah, that's true, but that might be not what you want. You want to take a little red out for
For my
webcam.
face, yeah. Yeah.
Feels sexy on there.
Thank you. I did new eye makeup. See? Ah. It's pretty, right? Okay. Back to work. I don't know. Which one do I want to get rid of? This one.
Okay.
There's bugs in his helmet. All right, guys, back to work. I'm totally not paying attention. I'm sure everyone's saying hi to you, but I'm not sure. All right. So you want to... Okay, first let's skip down to the settings. All right, video bitrate, audio bitrate and format, frame rate, resolution, and keyframe interval. Now, all these words might sound very foreign to you, but just breathe. It's five things. You set them up one time, and you should never really have to tinker with them again unless weird stuff starts happening. But mostly, you're just going to have to set this up one time. It's a one and done. Once it's in your OBS, you can shut your OBS down as many times as you want, that your settings are going to remain the same, and then all you'll have to do is change whatever you want. Like if you want to change a color or your words or, link to some video or something like that, you'll have to have all that prepared ahead of time. So these are really just five things that you have to set up, and once you've done it once, you could uninstall OBS and reinstall it. You don't even really have to look back at this. You'll know exactly how to do all this. But I'm gonna show you because I'm super, super nice like that. But before I do that, I just wanna see, if anyone has any questions. So let me go to the comments and see what we got. Set it and forget it. Exactly. One and done. Where can you find a keyframe? I will show you that. What happened to his accent? I'm not part Indian. Harry Beaver tells us to get a room. Wait, are you asking Mr. Perfect if he's part Indian? What happened to his accent? Oh, Mr. Perfect.
My accent's fake.
What do you use as service since Periscope isn't listed? What do you mean as service? Service. Is it under settings, Shiny? Service. Mine doesn't say service anywhere that I see. Oh, server? Oh, it's custom streaming. I think that's what you're asking me. At the top? Yes, yeah, stream type, custom streaming server. I think that answers your question, but let me know. Let me know if that does not answer it. Or if it does. Is that the guy with the deep voice? Yes. Hey, Flash. Cover up your stream key? Yeah, it's covered, Amy. You can't see it. Oh, hey, Trina. That's okay. Yeah, you can watch the replay. If I wasn't in my jammies, yeah, right? I got a lower third going. I know, right, Perry Bird? I'm bossy today. I see you. I guess I'll play 1910 music to avoid the copyright thing. There you go. Perfect, Amy. Perfect. I like the way you think. Okay, so I think I got caught up with the old comments. Let's see if there's anything new. You're going to email me. Eric, awesome, thank you. Is mayonnaise an instrument? No, under stream, setting stream on OBS. Oh, thanks, perfect. Okay, yes, custom streaming URL. Okay, now let's go back to your producer server and stream name are always the same. The server is actually the same. It used to be different, but now the server is actually the same for everyone. So all of us, everyone using Periscope Producer, their URL is going to be the same. And then the stream key is based on the encoder that you have there. So if you end up creating a new encoder, like create a new source, you'll see that button when you're in your settings on Periscope. If you create a new source, that each source you create has its own stream key. So that may or may not change depending on if you accidentally delete one or accidentally create one. It makes no difference if you delete or create it. It's not gonna hurt anything. You just have to have one that you can use that has a stream key. So a good example of this was Eggdrop has a bunch of them. They have a bunch of different stream keys. And one time I broadcasted to one that Joey was already broadcasting to. Whereas if I had just used a different stream key, it really wouldn't have overlapped. We wouldn't have had any connection issues or anything weird. But because we were both live to the same stream key at the same time, we both just crashed and burned, and that was my bad. Hey, Spindome, I haven't seen you in a while. How are you? Thanks for inviting. All right, so now let's get into the next part of this lesson. Oh, actually not that part. So these are the settings that we're going to set up now. And I'm going to show you exactly how to do that. So I'm going to click settings down here in the lower right hand side. I click settings and then this comes up. So let me just go right down the list. So we'll start with setting up our video bitrate to 800 kilobytes a second. I don't know if that's really, if I'm saying the right thing, but that's what it looks like. So let's go with that. So I'm going to go into output and I'm going to check my bitrate here. Now you can see my bitrate I actually have set at 791. It was at 800, and oftentimes when I would go live, I would get weird diagnostics saying that I was running at like 810 or something, that it was like too much, and I would drop frames. So I just lowered my bitrate a little bit to 791. It seems to work fine. Don't seem to have any problems when I'm streaming. So the max is 800. So as long as you're 800 or below, you should be good. You don't want to be too low because then it's just going to look really crappy. Okay, so you set that up there under output. Oh, and actually, okay, output. I think you'll have to actually first change output mode to advanced. Once you change output mode to advanced, you'll see these three tabs, and it's going to be under that first tab, streaming, under rate control, CBR, bit rate. You're going to want that to be 800. The next setting that we want to set up is the audio bit rate and format. 64 kilobytes per second to 96 kilobytes per second, AAC or AAC-LC. Do I know what that means? No, I just know that I just need to match that. So I forget if that's here. Yeah, that's here. So you'll click the audio tab. So just make sure if you're not seeing this, make sure your output mode is set to advanced. Click audio and then drop this audio bitrate down to 64. Sorry, I'm probably getting ahead of myself here. I don't see this part on here, but you do have to make sure this is set up correctly. Maybe this defaulted to the right one, but just make sure this top one is 44.1 kilohertz. And then the frame rate is 30 frames per second. So let's see, where's that video? Yes. Common frames per second values, 30, okay? So just make sure this is 30 FPS. FPS is frames per second. 30 frames per second. Resolution is recommended 960 by 540. Now this one is, you usually have to do something a little different. You can see mine for my scaled resolution is 908 by 512. That was the closest option I could find. And as you can see, the resolution's pretty good. It's a lot higher quality than what I used to have. So it probably has a lot more to do with your camera than the number here. As long as you get as close as possible without going over on your resolution, you're looking for, what was it, 960 by 540? Mm-hmm. 960 by 540. And then the last setting, we want to make sure that the keyframe interval is every 2 seconds in OBS, or if you're using Wirecast, it's every 60 frames. So this is under advanced, maybe? No. Sorry, I just have to find it really quick. General, stream, output. I think it's under output. Yes. So it's under output. Make sure output mode is advanced. Under streaming, it's right here, the keyframe interval. You just want to make sure that's set to 2. Keyframe interval should be 2. And then OK. And you are all set up. You can start tinkering. You can start building stuff in here. You can start using all sorts of stuff, having fun, teaching people how to do it themselves. You can show them how to use Egg Drop, which maybe we'll do soon. What, my hair is just, OK, everything's backwards when you use OBS. So it feels like, I don't know, everything feels like it's on the wrong side. Like this hair, like I can't, my brain can't wrap around how to fix my hair when I use Producer. Okay. Anyway, that's really important part of the training. No 4K, only 800. Yeah, correct. For all of them, Shiny? For all of them. Can you reduce frames per second to 24 or 25? Probably. No, actually, I don't think that was an option on mine, but maybe. I can't see why not. These are mainly maximums. What about bitrate? That was the first one that I showed. What was that you were showing, Taylor? A website? Sorry, I just came in the middle of it. This is called OBS, so what I'm using here to have this little thing down here and I'm using my computer is OBS. So what I'm doing right now is I'm sharing my computer screen, so you're seeing my whole screen, and this whole thing, this box that you'll see at the top over here, it'll say OBS 19.0.3. You want to download that, unless you already have Wirecast or you use something else for streaming game scopes or something, but I use OBS. It's open broadcasting software. If you just look up like download OBS, it's free. You just have to download it on your computer and then you'll have this program. And that once in, it'll look exactly like this, except you won't have like a video and a little thing on the bottom. You have to build all that. And I went over how to put all that in the beginning. You'll just have to set up your settings. So it'll just be like a black screen. You just go into the settings, set them up like I just showed you, and then you'll be able to start going live using your computer instead of your. And if you have a Mac, you probably have a pretty decent webcam anyway, so you can do that instead of your phone, which just makes it easier for showing. Like, say you want to show your own website. Let's go look at my website. Why not? Boom. My website needs a lot of work, but it's okay. Boom. So if I wanted to kind of show you guys around in here, like, okay, if you're wondering how to support Fem Yoga, there's a lot of different ways you can do it. You can either click it over here in the left side menu, support Fem Yoga. You can click it in the header menu, support Fem Yoga. You can scroll down and click support Fem Yoga right under my intro video. All three buttons are going to bring you to this same page, which explains what the sponsorships are for. You can see the different sponsorships levels, and then you can go ahead and purchase that. Or you can contribute an item from the Fem Yoga wish list by clicking this. Boom. All sorts of cool stuff. Which reminds me that I got some books from Sarah and I want to give her a shout out. So let me come back here. Hi. All right. Let me grab them. Boom. Sarah, one of our newest followers, sponsors, contributors, she's amazing, amazing, amazing. She sends so many super hearts. I love her. She's one of our most, she's actually is our most recent gold level sponsor. And I went to the post office today and found that she had sent me two really awesome books. These are like $35 books each. This is so helpful. These are the key muscles of yoga. So it actually is going to give me better understanding of all the muscles because, you know, I learned a lot of different anatomy, but there's so many muscles in the body. There's just so much to learn all the time, and to learn it from different perspectives, different books, different teachers is really, really beneficial for your teaching and for you as students. So thank you, thank you, thank you, Sarah. This is amazing. And then the other one is like a supplement to this. It's by the same company. That's volume one. Those are the key muscles. And then volume two is the key poses. So then it goes through and it shows you how each, well, that's a weird picture. how each picture affects the different muscle groups and why and how and proper alignment. So it's a really, really, really awesome, awesome, awesome way to support the channel if you want anything like that. Oh, well, that's the table of contents in the end, but yeah, you get the idea. So thank you, Sarah. You're amazing. Mwah! Thank you, thank you, thank you. And now I'm going to go back to your comments because I know I'm totally ADD today. Hand pose. Hey, Blaine, how are you? Ashley, I didn't see your comment, but I'm going to see it right now. You love the wish list. Thank you, Shiny. Woohoo, getting fancy, Cash. So happy for you and your scope success. Good job, girl. Proud of you. Thank you, Ashley. You're a sweetheart. Thank you so much. And thank you for being here. If you guys have any questions, feel free to shout them out. Oh, love you too, Mindy. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Mwah. 96 audio might sound less tinny. Does it sound tinny? It's probably just the sound of my laptop fan, right? Audio tracks was what I meant. Okay, so you had asked for all of them, audio. Oh no, I only do the top one. At 64, I do the top one, but never saying maybe try 96. I haven't tried that, I don't think. You're welcome, Trina. Hey, Pablo, hola. Gracias para invitar? No, inviting. How I would say thank you for inviting two followers. How would I say inviting and followers? Hoppa! Can I see how you make yoga? You can, just check out my replays. Thank you, Mindy. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I work my butt off, so I love it. Tinny and echo from reflected sound. That might be, I don't know how to really fix that. I guess if I moved you like up taller, but then you'd just be looking down on me. I think I'm gonna have to leave it the way it is. Okay, gracias, para o por invitar tus seguidores. No, son tus seguidores. Por. Okay, gracias por invitar tus seguidores, Pablo. Muy bien, gracias. Now the best yoga. Lou, thank you. Thank you for inviting your followers. Actually, Lou, gracias por invitar tus seguideros. Yes. Woot, 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 woot. Okay. Any questions on OBS? I know Shiny's going through some of this with us. I think maybe Trina, Ashley might be looking at some of this. So that is how that works. And then I get a lot of questions about what is egg drop. So I'm going to show you what egg drop is. Oh, wait, we still didn't finish going through this, did we? Sorry, ADD. Okay, anything else on here? How does it work? Screenshots. Yep, this shows you the image. You're gonna wanna click create new source if you don't have this already. If you have this is everything you need. Just the URL and the stream key. Then you're gonna put the URL and the stream key into the custom streaming server under stream settings in OBS. Oh, they didn't show you all the other settings, but make sure you change all the settings. And then once you, oh yeah, of course, I should show you that. Once you have everything set up how you want it, you have to click this top button here on the right that says Start Streaming. Once you click Start Streaming, you're going to see in your Periscope settings a button that says Preview Broadcast. Just like this here, Preview Broadcast. You'll click that and then you'll get this page here. So you can't just go live like you normally would. You don't click the red button. You have to go in through your settings, through Periscope Producer. Then you'll see Preview Broadcast, and then you'll get your normal, what you're used to seeing. You type in your title, you turn your super hearts on or off, post to Twitter, post to Facebook, all of that, and then you just click Go Live. And then you'll be seeing yourself live on your phone that you're using to broadcast from. And that's how you can track comments if you're not using Egg Drop, but I highly recommend using Egg Drop, especially if you have an Android, because my phone's freaking out from this. So I'm going to show you what Egg Drop is. And what I'm going to do is actually not show you on there. I'm going to come back for a moment, and I'm going to link right to this page. So I'm going to click New Window Capture. I'm gonna grab Egg Drop. Oops, I missed. Okay, there we go. Oh, hey, Nick. Hey, Matt. What's up? What's up? What's up? You'll pass on Egg Drop? All right, Amy, how come? You don't like Egg Drop? A Taylor dance only needs three moves. She dances like her husband, The Flash. Okay, my husband's not The Flash, and The Flash has more than three dance moves, and so do I. Just saying. All right, so let me see if I can zoom in on this a little because it looks a little small on my screen. Let's try 150. It's a little big, but hopefully that's good for your compu for your cell phone screen. And I just want to scroll down and see if I'm missing anything. We need to have a femme yoga dance. Yeah, we do. We do. I think I actually set up OBS for Twitch a while back and never used it. Might have to look again. Perfect, James. You're already halfway there then. Excelente. Muy excelente. She's awake, isn't she? Wait, did she start to drink already? Who are you talking about? Are you talking about me? She's awake, isn't she? You talking about me? You guys, you're rude. You're rude. Okay, and this is exactly how I go look at my comments because I miss them and I just go back, I read them, and I go back to the top. And then I also could turn, I could make it so that I can only see who invited. And then I could do a shout out to everyone who invited. Thank you, Lou. Thank you, Pablo. Thank you, Spin Gnome. Thank you, iDesign. Thank you, EJ. Thank you, Kat. Thank you, Logan. Thank you, Ryan. And thank you, Manny, for inviting your followers. Thank you, Matt, for inviting your followers. This is a good way to promote people to invite people. Thank you, James, for inviting your followers. It's kind of like, you know, that moment of truth. It's like you could tell who invited and who didn't, you know? And also, if you show this on your screen, you can see that I just got two more invites from doing that. It'll be a reminder, but it will also be like kind of like an accountability. You know, everyone can see that they didn't invite, and it's just kind of like, okay, it just reminds them to invite. You can also see who took screenshots, if anyone. So it says I took a screenshot, Alex and I designed. They could have been taking screenshots for OBS, for learning some of this, for the FemYoga.com, anything, who knows. But some people don't like to have screenshots taken, especially if you see, like, say Alex was just like nonstop, just screenshot, 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 and it was like a yoga scope. You know what I mean? Like, you can decide if you know, your comfort level there or not. So I pretty much watch everything in my stream except the joins. A bunny bear, what is that? A bundle of information. Thank you, Mindy. Denial is not just a big river in Egypt. Denial, what's that from? That's from, I know a lot of people say that, but it's also from the new guy. If you are missing your side menu from Egg Drop, click the Eggbot head and you're gonna see your home, your settings. If you have premium, you're gonna see who you have blocked and who your mutual followers are. A bunny who is cute. Okay, easy, easy with the cute stuff. And I'm too zoomed in to actually scroll down, I think. Yeah, I can't actually scroll down to show you that. Maybe if I go down all the way on this part. No, still can't show you. But there is some more options there on the side. Then if you want to see everything, you'll click the word stream, and this is probably what you'll see. What you're actually going to see when you first go to your Egg Drop page, once you have it all set up, you're going to go to, first you're just going to go to eggdrop.com. Let's do that together. And this is what you're going to see. You're not going to be logged in, so this is going to look a little different on the left. Instead of seeing a button that says log out, which you actually can't see because I'm so freaking zoomed in. There we go. Instead of seeing log out, you'll see a button that says sign up. So you're going to click sign up. You're going to create a premium account or a free account. You can get this completely for free if you want. You can't use all the features if you have it for free, but at least you can use a lot of the cool stuff. And it'll get you hooked, and eventually you'll get premium and we'll all be happy. So you're going to click sign up. And then once you've created your account, you just have to confirm it in your email address. And then come back on here and confirm your account. It tells you exactly how to verify your account right here. If you're using a premium account, you'll also need to go into your settings and link your Periscope account right here. And this is how people are using, they're blocking when they're not paying attention. Certain words get automatically blocked. You'll see people playing hangman, blackjack, using it to check the time, check the weather, check definitions. So it has some really, really cool functionality, and that's Egg Drop. That's what you're seeing, is this feature right here. So that's pretty much it to say. Oh yeah, and then once you have it all set up, you have your settings all set up how you want them, and you want to go live, you go live with hashtag Egg Drop in the title. And then it will remind you right on the homepage. Oh God, they took it down. Oh my God. Okay, well, I guess it won't remind you anymore. You just have to remember, make sure that you put hashtag Egg Drop in your broadcast title. They just changed this, so I might have to remind them that it now doesn't say how to do it, but you have to just put go live with hashtag Egg Drop in your broadcast title, just like you can see mine has now. And then what you'll do is you'll go to eggdrop.com/your username, mine being FemYoga Taylor. Once you're in there, it's gonna look like this to you. So you can see that Trina has sent me the most hearts with almost 6,000 hearts on this broadcast, followed by Elusive with almost 4,000, Mindy with over 1,000, and James is trying to catch up, almost at 600. Matt's moving his way up, he just hit 300. And you can scroll all the way through everyone. And this is how Flash puts the heart race on his broadcasts, and you see that like with Egg Drop and other broadcasters. Sometimes they put this heart race from Egg Drop right at the top of their broadcast. And if you want to hide this side menu once you're done using it, you just click the Eggbot head. Now, for me personally, I don't use the heart race very often, so I guess I could. I used to a lot. And then I don't really have a lot of use for this stuff down here either. And you can also link this to your Busker. So you can put your Busker username and click save. And then if I just want to see my stream, I mainly just click the word stream. It doesn't look like a button, but you click it and it'll come up like this. You like this website? Thanks, Matt. He needs to do his Flash Whisper on the ASMR broadcast? Okay, I'll tell him. You like this thing? Cool. Me too. Me too, me too, me too. Any questions on that? It seems like everyone's following along pretty well. I'm going to come back now and you can let me know what your thoughts are. Does anyone want to get on this scope with me? I didn't see any takers on that. I just kind of want to show you guys how we could split screen if anyone is feeling daring enough. You don't have to show your face. You can just show like something funny or just nothing. It could just be like a wall, just so we can show how we can conference people into scopes. Everyone tell Flash, this is how you do it. It's really easy because it keeps saying like, oh, one day we're going to be able to do this. I'm like, we can do this now. We've been able to do this for a long time. And I just remembered I can't see anyone's comments. Just need an idea to scope that's not boring. James, don't overthink it. It won't be boring. You just got to do it. Got to do it to it. Do your art. You should have painted that painting on scope. People love watching that kind of stuff. I'd love to, but how? Okay, Trina. So, your choice. You can either Google Hangout call me at femyogataylor@gmail.com, or you can tell me, well, actually, do you have a Zoom account? You probably don't have Zoom. Let's do either Google Hangouts or Zoom. If you have Zoom, I prefer Zoom, but if you don't have Zoom, it's like Skype. If you don't have Zoom, just say no Zoom, and then you can call me on Google Hangouts. If you don't know how to do that, I'm going to show you guys right now. Although, first I'm going to hide. Wait, you guys can't see anything. All right, let me just make sure you're not going to see any personal information if I try to do this. Yeah, you would. You would see people's names. So let me just do this here. We should just call Fowl. Mindy, are you still in here? I feel like we should call him. Mindy, if you're in here, we're going to call Fowl. Lonnie's in here. Lonnie, hello. Let's call Fowl. No Zoom. Okay. So if you want to just go, you just go to Google, either your Gmail account, or you can just look up like Google Hangouts, and it'll be femyogataylor@gmail.com. And then you just call me. It'll be like a video call, and then we'll be on a video call, and then I'll show you guys how to like move that into the channel, if you want. No pressure. I know it's kind of, you know, you probably weren't prepared to do this right now, but I feel like this would be fun to just call Fowl. Let's just do it. What time is it? Okay, it's 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, 3. It's almost 3 a.m. in the UK. He's not going to answer, but let's just try it. Let's do it. Oh my God, this is so funny. Today. Nope. Fail. Okay. I gotta put pants on, makeup, make a call. Okay. Can you get more than one stream with you? Yes. Where you at? Yay, Trina's coming. I think she's coming. Like your new bat. Thank you, Lonnie. I know, Mindy. We're just like calling Fowl at 3 a.m. like, what's up, Fowl? Me, Mindy, and Lonnie just wanted to say hi. Oh, yeah, and the rest of the world. We're on public scope right now. What's up? I feel like he wouldn't care. That's why I called him, of all people. All right, so let me close Zoom because nobody has Zoom except Tanique. Beautiful whispering reader. Wow, Thurston, thank you so much. I know I'm being pretty excited right now, pretty loud. I don't always whisper. I pretty much am only calm and whispery when I'm doing yoga or those scopes. Is it Google Hangout or Zoom? It's Google Hangout or Zoom. Either way. Either way, it's the same email address. Oh, thank you, Dee. Remember when I used to do these? Look how nice my camera is now. We are taking it up a notch. Should I walk back in? Hola, Juan. How are you? I don't know why I say hola to you. He's like, I don't speak Spanish. It's just because your name is Juan. It just seems like I should say hola to you. He wouldn't because you are so cool. Yes, exactly. Exactly. I like the way you think. All right, I gotta keep an eye on here and see if anyone's calling me. I do have a message from Eggdrop. Oh yeah, they changed my password and didn't tell me what it was. It says I'm logged in though. Let me, just curious if I can add new moderators while I'm waiting. Settings. No, I can't. Let's see if I open it in an incognito window. And then log in. Oh, no, not as I drop. As me. And then password. Thank you for the hearts, you guys. Yay, incoming video call. Well, this is very exciting. Where is it? Answer. Yes. Hello. You can't see me, can you? Let's see if I can. Yeah, I can't show myself because my camera's being used by my OBS, but can you hear me? Can you hear me? I don't think she can hear me. How do I, can I like write to her? I can see her, but we can't hear her and she can't hear me. So this is interesting. Why can't I show my camera? All right, you guys, I'm gonna go away for a second here. Just look at egg drop. Oh wait, don't look at that. Crap! I'm gonna have to delete this stupid scope. Okay, look at this, that. And I'm going to take my video source away. See if she can hear me now. Why not? Oh, let me try this. Did that work? I can't hear you. Okay, I think she's watching my scope, so at least she can hear me. I can see her lips moving, but I can't hear her. Why can't I hear her? Makes no sense. Camera problem. Why is it a camera problem? Default, save. That's so weird. Okay, Trina, I'm gonna try to call you right back, okay? Let me try to call you. Is that okay? Okay, cool. Let's try it. Very odd. So, sorry guys, stand by. I'm totally not seeing comments. This scope is sponsored by Femi Yoga Taylor. Yeah, have I tried turning it off and on again? That's what I'm trying right now. Okay, so I took away. All right, but the microphone is still hooked up with you guys. And I don't know how to do that. Okay. Let me just try it again. Let me just try to call her because she's waiting. Okay. Where are we? This one. Call. Accept. And call her. Where'd it go? It says I'm in a video call, but I see nothing. Oh, here we go.
There you are.
Yay! Okay. All right. So I can see and hear you now. Now let's see.
Yeah.
No, I don't think, wait, I don't know if they can. Can you hear me on scope?
I'm watching you on my phone.
Okay. Thank you, Mindy. Yeah. All right. I am accepting the call. Okay, yeah. So that's what we're doing. We're doing a Google Hangout call on the laptop. I'm just going to quickly just make sure I can't see you on Hangouts. Yeah, I know. You know my email? Yeah, I know. Call Lon and interview him on the spot. Okay, everyone call at once. Hello, everyone. All right. You're changing your name. Okay. All right. Okay. All right, I think I got caught up on comments. Now I'm going to tinker behind the scenes. Oh, let me show you guys something really quick. On here. Oh, you can't see me. That's okay. On here. To do some, okay, so what I'm going to start doing, I'm going to start making changes to this where you guys can't see it live, and then I can update it all live at once. So what I'm clicking is studio mode, I know it looks super, super crazy when we're live and when we're on display capture because it's like a bajillion million of them in one screen. But the stuff on the left is going to be the edited version. And until you click transition, it's not going to go live. So that's what I'm going to be tinkering with right now. I'm going to add window capture. I'm going to call it Trina. I'm going to try to grab Trina. We'll see if this works. There she is. And then I'm gonna try to crop this so it doesn't look so weird.
Oh boy.
Just like it looks like, with the side chat and everything. So let's fit this to the screen. And then, wait, oh yeah, I'm still, okay, let me take that. Is that better now?
This is so cool. I've never ever known how to do this.
I love it so much. Let me see if I can turn you up so they can hear you better. There we go. And now let me crop. You guys are seeing this all live. I don't know why. I thought you wouldn't see it, but I don't know. I'm learning to 100. All right. So I could like crop this. And obviously we would have this all set up before we were live normally. This is just like we're teaching you guys, so we're gonna do it live. We're gonna do it live. What does Flash always say? Fuck it, we'll do it live. And that's what we're doing. All right, so I would make it all nice and pretty, chop just enough off that it's not showing any little gray. Cool. And then I'll chop off the other side. What was that, 200? Oh yeah, there we go. I could probably even go a lot higher on this side. Now, the only thing is, I don't know how I'm gonna get my own face in here, but I'm gonna try. See, but I'm so little. How can I get myself like split screen with you?
Yeah, so that's what you can do on Facebook is like the split screen where it's like sideways
And
so
I've
we're
done
both.
it before with people using Zoom. Actually, maybe we did use Google Hangouts. I did this once with Dinesh, Perry Monkey. But yeah, so why can't I? Let me go. I think what I have to do is I have to tinker with it on Google Hangouts. I have to make it so that my screen actually looks different. Like, what's this? No, not screen share. Oh, well, there's me. That's not what I want.
There we go. Now you're big.
Yeah, but then you're small.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, because I want to leave you big, so let me just experiment with this. This is what I'm gonna do. Oh no! Why won't it let me change it more? Don't mess with me. Come in. Trina. Transform. Edits. All right. So, this is gonna be weird. I'm gonna end up chopping off some of your face. You might wanna like angle your camera, like, I don't know, up higher. I'm gonna end up chopping off some of your chin, I think.
Okay, I can like turn it up a little
Because
bit.
I'm trying to, you know what I mean? Like, I'm trying to just take that bottom
Yeah.
part away. It's like creeping up on you. All right, cool. And thank you for being such a good sport about this. I'm like, I have no idea how this is gonna go.
Of course.
All right. People are probably like, who is this person?
Yeah, I know. I'm like, who the heck?
Okay. You can still hear and see me, right?
Yep.
Okay, cool. And then the top a little bit more. Okay. So that basically crops it the way that I want without stretching you out or anything. And then what I would do is I would like make it whatever size. So I'll probably make it a little bit smaller. And maybe put it like right about there. It's maybe just a smidge smaller, but that's pretty good. And then I'm gonna try to figure out a way to put myself in here. Not sure how it's gonna go. What might happen is you might lose me on Google Hangouts as far as being able to hear me or see me or something because I'm gonna try to switch the camera into OBS.
Okay, I can see you right on here.
Okay, cool. Yeah, this looks like this is working. Yay! All right. So I'm again going to transform this to fit to the screen and shrink myself down. Yeah, but see, my size is weird. Yeah, I'll have to crop mine too. Okay, cropping. Cropping. Stand by. Really don't need this side stuff. There we go. Let's try that. Boom, boom. It's pretty close, you know what I mean? Like, you could tinker with this to make it more perfect before you went live and stuff. But you get the idea, and then I could just kind of like crop off a little more of, actually, either one of us. I think you're a little bigger than me, so let me try to crop you a little more, just like that wall. We don't really need to see that way. We'll be able to see you better, I think. Is it pulling you the other way? Why isn't it pulling you more? Oh, am I cropping the wrong thing? I'm cropping the wrong thing. Reset. I didn't actually have you. I had like something else in the background. Just cropping it. Oh, there we go. That's you. All right, yeah. See how I can kind of like cut that off a little bit more and then hopefully drag you over there so you're not cut off at all. So, I mean, I think that's okay. It gives you guys the idea of what you could do with having a split screen. You know, I'm like,
right.
My OCD is like acting up a bit with it, but I think you get the gist. So, transition, and then I'll come out of studio mode. And I think that's pretty much how we would do it. And then the only thing I guess would be audio. Can you guys hear her at all? I mean, you can probably hear her somewhat, but I feel like it's probably pretty quiet. I'd like to be able to, well, but then how would I hear her? How's the audio for her? You can hear her? Like, is it enough? It's good enough? I mean, how would I make this professional quality? Like, say I wanted to bring someone on and interview them. I don't want it to be so gritty. No, she's good. She is good. I know. She's patient, too. Okay. Your landscape,
so this
she's
portrait. All done on the OBS, you said?
Yes. Yep. This I did this all just in there. So I basically, what I did is I grabbed a window capture to grab you. And then I did a, for myself, it was a video capture. Let me show you my display here. I'm going to put the display on top. So we're going to vanish for a second just so you guys can see like behind the scenes. So in here, this is all the sources. So all I needed just like, I have a bunch of stuff going here right now, but all you needed to do what we're doing is this, which is, I called it Trina, but this is a window capture. So I could make it something else. Like I could click a different window that I have open, but I clicked Google Hangouts. And then the video capture device is just my camera looking at me. And then I just like, you know, cropped it and stuff. So it's really just those two things. We can actually hide everything else. So I'll hide that, I'll hide that, hide that. Yeah, everything's hidden now. And then, you know, and so the little bar on the bottom, we wouldn't have that, obviously, but yeah. And then someone made a good point, Never said that you're in portrait and I'm in landscape. And that's why like, it was kind of a weird like ratio to get us all linked up.
Okay, so, yes. True.
Yeah, so if we had it switch, like if we had you in, don't switch it now, but if we had it switched before, could make it look more.
You'd have to totally
no, do everything over again.
Yeah.
All right, so, are you guys seeing this display? Are you seeing, no, they're seeing, okay. So then I kind of like the way the color and text looks there. So the color and text is different. That was just like two more sources. Let me show you again. So that's text. And color source. So all you have to do is just click the little plus sign and then click whatever you want to add in. Like if you want to add text, the video capture device is just your webcam. It's really simple. If you click it, it'll just like pop up a picture of you. You don't have to, it's not like you have to set up anything really. And then window capture is one I use the most. I use that if I want to show something on YouTube or on a website or pick like a music. Or if I want to do like show people how to use egg drop and even how to showing people how to use, actually to show people how to use this, I use display capture because then that just shows your entire computer screen. And then you can click around and show people exactly how you're doing it, kind of. You can see sometimes it gets like buried under other stuff and you can't see everything I'm doing, but it's pretty good. It's one thing, here's like a pro tip for everyone. Don't use stupid browser source. It sucks. All right, I'm going to hide the display again. Hello. So anything you'd like to say to the people in the room and the replayers?
Oh, God. hey. This is totally random, but
It is totally right. Okay, both of you have good sound. I hear both loud and clear. Really? That's funny because I feel like I barely hear her. So all we do from producer itself is copy the info into OBS. Yes, but then you also have to preview the broadcast and go live from producer. So you have to actually, you can't go live your normal little red camera way. You have to actually go into your settings in producer and then click like preview broadcast and then you can go live from there. Hey, Sean, you haven't tried the split screen. Yes, you're going to try it now. That's awesome. Hey, Lou. Reverb. Oh, there's reverb. I know my fan is going crazy right now. Echo on her. Really? What did I do? You guys said it was good and then I went and moved it. Major reverb. Why is it when people say that? Because I've seen a lot of people say that, reverb. Oh, it's like echoey. Let me try something, guys. Let me try, oh, you know why? Maybe this. Wait, now we might not be able to hear you. Try saying something, Trina.
Hey, guys.
Is that better? Is it, I think that should take away the echo. That was my own fault.
Hey, guys. Is that better?
It's better. It's better. I'm just listening to it on my phone. Yeah. So what I did, I'll show you guys. This is fun. Thank you guys. This is, I'm like, I'm learning everything live. Okay. So if I give you the display again, if you click this button, what I had my desktop audio on. So Trina, just try not to say anything for 1 second. I had this on. So that's what you were getting. It was like feeding, like you're hearing it not only through the microphone, but you were also hearing it through like the desktop audio or something. So I just had to turn that off. And then once I muted that, I think the echo went away and you can still hear her. So I think that solved it. Thank you guys for the feedback. We would not have known. When you're broadcasting on Scope through OBS, what is the lag time? Let's see. Here, let me touch my nose, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Like 6 seconds, about. Anna Kendrick. Me or her? I don't know who Anna Kendrick is. Is that bad? Yes, single source. Yes, reverb is an audio effect in audio production. She has echo going on. Interesting scope. Yeah, not you, but her. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, we got that fixed. It gone. Cool.
Cool.
So if you want to put emojis in the chat, everyone can follow you. And then, yeah, this was pretty much everything, unless anyone else has questions.
Ooh. Right.
If you want to. If you want people to follow.
Oh, no, I will. I don't really scope too much. I mean, I want to, but I just want to do, like, interesting things. But I'll be happy to have people follow me if they wish.
Yeah, definitely. If someone wants to know if you're an actor or a singer.
Oh, no. Just a mom.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah, so everyone follow her and make sure to tell her that she should scope. And now she can do cool computer scopes from her computer. It's pretty fun. It doesn't take a tech genius to do this, you know. It just takes a little bit of patience.
Right. So thank you guys.
Thank you. Thank you who followed me.
Thank
you for being here, and I'll probably see you in Scope again soon. And thank you, thank you, thank you.
Yes, thank you. This is very, very informational, and I appreciate it.
Good. I'm glad. I'll talk to you again soon then.
Okay. Thank you. All right.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. So then she's gone. So then I can just take really easy. I can just right click on my video capture device and fit to screen and then hide that other little, what are you seeing in the background? Oh, that, boom. Hide that, bring this back to the top. See, really quick and easy, painless. Which way should I move, this way? There we go. More centered. Yay, this is fun for me. Guest you? You want to be guested in? Guest me. Call me. Mindy and Dana. Thanks for guessing. Oh, guesting, yes. How are you doing the title bar at the bottom of the split screen? Yes, PJ, let me tell you this. Who's Anna Kendrick? First, I want to figure out who that is. Isn't she like a big blonde lady? Oh, no. She's not a big blonde lady. She's the opposite of that. Well, thank you. I like her nose. Her nose is much better than mine, so I'll take it. The one that has you first has the lag sound. Is it better now, Mindy, on both, you and Lonnie both? Okay, wait, let me say how I'm doing that bar on the bottom of the screen. Matt, call, wait, Matt, or no, Zemo, whoever it was, call me. And in the meantime, I'm going to show you guys how I do that. It's color source. So I have the text on top and then the color source. And what I did to make it that bar is if you right-click on it and then click transform, stretch to screen. If you click stretch to screen, it'll fill up your whole box with the blue color or whatever color, and then you can adjust it so it's not just a square. Then you can adjust it like this way. If I can grab it, I can't grab it. That, you know, you can like do it up and down like that. Then you gotta like find your little happy OCD happy place. Maybe there. No, I think that's a little too tall. I don't know. It's fine. It's fine. Let's just leave it. Okay. It's too fun. Too fun. You're too fun. Mindy, Indiana. I know, it's fun to say, isn't it? Thank you, Ryan. It was fun, wasn't it? It's like a gaming channel. Hey, Quaz. Quaza, how are you? An actress. Yes, yeah, she is an actress. Yes, Trina, that was fun. Thank you so much. All 30 people should call at once. You both have nice faces. Well, thank you. I'll call you tomorrow because I'm chilling, going to sleep soon. Okay, Matt, sounds good. So many menu options. That's true. You're welcome, PJ. But the person that checks in first, me, has the lag, even though I had been on for minutes. Oh, weird. On the sound? Oh, you mean like from my mouth? If you leave and come back, does it do that? Sometimes it's just like the app on your phone itself. Hopefully I'm not lagging, I don't know. Came in late, so sorry. What software are you using? Hey Gio, I'm using OBS, Open Broadcasting Software. Let me know if you have any questions about it. Zemo, are you calling me or was that a joke? This is a fun way to make like new friends, you know? Strange sound. Yeah, it's lagging. Like the comments, when you read it, we get it before you. Open Boop software. Yes. Boop. Did I just put a big old fingerprint on there? Periscope problems, not you. Oh, okay. How do we call you? FemYogaTaylor@gmail.com. If you want a video, call in and be on the channel. Name same. Hello. Do you want to call in? You guys should all call in. Why don't you guys decide if you're going to call in? If you're going to call in, do a Google Hangouts call to Fem Yoga Taylor. And while I wait for you to do that, I'm chilling. We'll listen to music. I'll actually show you that. There. Okay, I'll be back. Okay, yeah, it's like we're on hold. I know. It's like when Flash took that bathroom break and he had to unplug his head and he just like ran. This Periscope has been brought to you by Fem Yoga Taylor. Yeah, sponsored by. Can you Hangouts and Periscope at the same time? Only if you're using Producer. Can we call in by phone? I mean, for what? Hey again, Logan. I guess I still don't have all of it. Getting closer though. Oh, tell me what, Shiny. Call in. Call in. Then you can share your screen with me. You don't really, I don't have to share it. You can, like, if you want to just call me and share your screen, I won't put you on live. If you want to just, like, I can look at it and see what the problem might be if you want. Hey, Dave Ayers, we are showing people how to use OBS and Periscope Producer. If we call in, do we win 2 tickets to Country Jam? No, you don't. Only another 2 hours to go. You are crazy, girl. You're crazy. You're crazy. So, make sure you share this. Make sure you follow me. And I'm just checking something really quick. Okay. Yeah. It's pretty perfect. I missed how once you get it looking the way you want, you go live. Oh, yeah, yeah, that's the easy part. That is easy. I actually left up that little screenshot, so let me show you. Window capture. Oh, wrong window capture. Not that one. This one. Boom. Bye. All right, this button right here. Okay. When you... Oh, wait, actually, first, rewind. You want your page, your Periscope Producer, to look like this. You want it to say Preview Broadcast, but what you have to do first, bonk, is click over here where mine says Stop Streaming. You just have to click Start Streaming. So click Start Streaming on OBS and give it like 30 seconds or so. And after, within about 30 seconds or less, maybe even, you should see this button that says Preview Broadcast. And then you'll click that. And then you'll see that you're normal. It'll look just like you just clicked the red button, but you'll be have gone through Producer. And then you can type that in. You'll know you're using Producer because you'll see this little like thing, this little dot that says Producer or something. I forget what it says, but you'll see that. And that's how you'll know. And then you'll just click Go Live like normal. Oops, I'm clicking the wrong thing to read your comments here. You're so sleepy, uh-huh. And let me hide that. Yay! And go back to this. So Producer sees that OBS is running. Yes, because of the stream key. Because OBS is running to the stream key, it goes and Periscope Producer will pick it up. And you won't be going live. Like when you click start streaming on OBS, you're not live. You're only live to your Periscope settings. Like no one can see that but you if you click preview. Or maybe like the people that work at Periscope. But you won't actually be live on Periscope until you click go live on Periscope. You'll still be able to put in a title and everything like that. Yes, thank you, Matt. Yes, follow me. Blair is asking, where's the yoga? The yoga is in the replays. I didn't do yoga today. I probably won't. Scope doesn't want to play on my TV. Oh, weird. Got all my girls that work on Periscope. Yes, yes, I love Periscope. I think it has quite a future ahead of it. Should be good. So you can test it right now, Shiny, if you're doing it. You can click Start Streaming and just see if you get the preview broadcast thing in your settings. I know you'll probably have to leave and come back, but you can check it if you want. Any other questions? So anybody maybe new in the room have any questions about OBS, anything about egg drop, anything like that, or any questions about Fem Yoga in general, anything that you want to share, anything you've been meaning to talk to me about? Here's your chance. Thank you for inviting Mindy. Let's see, who do we have? Oh, now I can see comments. Took long enough. You have a question? Okay. What's it gonna be? Oh, so many people here. Oh, thanks for the super hearts. Oh, I can't say your name, but thank you for the super hearts. And Johnny and Mitch and Logan and Ashley. I'm sorry that you all left before I got to thank you. I couldn't see anything happening on my screen. We're all old already in here. Well, only one question person. Where's the bondage? Yeah, she's not a question person. She's a troll. What do you sense around me, Angel? Indigo? What do I sense around you? I don't really get senses like that. I get more thoughts, and I can only have thoughts if I have data to go off of. You need a giant straw for that jug. Yes, so I can drink it through my nostrils. TV is about 12 seconds behind in lag with audio and no video. Do you have your HDMI cord hooked up and you have it like sent to the, you know, like what is it? FNF7, you got that? You probably got that. You know how to do it. I'd like to practice with you at another time. Okay, before I try using it, just not right now. Okay, Shiny, deal. Let's do it. And this is how me and Cyanide are going to be able to do split screens now. I'm a sweet little angel who never does anything wrong. Yes, and you wear a halo, don't you? Just like this. So proper. It's so sweet. Hey, Steve. How are you doing? I wonder how it would look drinking with nostrils, though. Now we're wearing a halo. This is happening. Well, I'm just trying to play it on the living room smart TV while I'm on the phone. Oh, just like through the browser? Oh, that's weird. I've never tried doing that before. I don't know why it's not working. Oh, do I have this in the background? Oh, that's not looking too good. Let's go ahead and hide that. And hide that. There we go. Halo. Hey, Katie. Any last questions before we end this? You see yourself, Steve? Yes. You like that song? I've got a fixed halo above my head. It's held up by my devil horns. I say that all the time. Okay. I'm going to give it... Oh, is that more super hearts? Someone just sent me super hearts. Thank you, super heart people. I don't know why I can't see who it was, but thank you. And shout out to Never, Shiny Hippie, Nick, Alex, Katie, Steve, Name Same, Trina, Lou, Eric, and Ryan. Thank you guys so much for being here. You're just in time for the end. I know. What should we do next? I feel like we should do Mad Gab now that I have a fancy camera. And I'm already all set up with OBS. We might as well just play Mad Gab, right? Oh, you're welcome, Shiny. Thank you for being here. Yes, thank you guys for being here. Yes, you get a shout out because I'm following you. So you're all awesome. And I think that looks like nobody has any questions. Hey, Murphy. Welcome. I was just about to end, but I think that you use Producer a lot. So if you have any questions about anything, let me know, or anything that you want to teach us, feel free. Hey, Levi. Is everyone getting here right now? I look like a real angel using a halo, right? Thank you, Trina. Trina, hey, half of this wouldn't be possible without you. I did do the split screen once, but not with this new camera. So that was a really important test. Thank you for being up for that. It was like very impromptu. Magab! Yeah, Nick's excited. Awesome. Good. You're just going to go to the PC. TV is frustrating. Okay, yeah. PC, you're going to be quick with Magab. It's okay, Levi. You don't have to be sorry. It's all good. It's been like an hour and a half. I just put some honey pepper bacon on to cook. That made up for everything, man. That makes up for it. I'm good. I know it well, but thank you. Okay, well, if you want to teach me anything, let me know. I like to learn. I've got to do my rounds. I'm leaving you in the capable hands of Blair. Okay, Blair, I'm about to leave this. No, he was using his smart TV browser to try to do it. Back to watching the storm move in. Ooh, you should scope it. People love thunderstorm scopes. You don't even have to talk. If you whisper, you'll get a lot of love. Let's see. There was one more thing that I was going to say. Oh, Murphy, one thing that we did on here that you might like was we did split screen. So I like had somebody call in on a Google Hangout call and we split screen each other so that people can see how to like bring people onto your scope, do interviews. And this is my brand new Logitech C920 camera, which is so nice. So nice. I've never had a high quality camera, so I'm just loving it. Oh, thank you, Katie. You're sweet. You did the other night. Steve, how did I miss it? Did you delete it? Maybe I'll watch the replay if you remind me at femyoga.com. Right, well, I just wanted to say I've been watching your yoga replays and they're amazing. Thank you, Blaine. You're sweet. Blair. I think your name is Blair. Blair. Thank you, you're a sweetheart. Gotta go. All right, watch you soon. All right, Matt, cool. That's what I was gonna send you. Oh, yeah, the camera? Yeah, it's okay. It's all right, Eric. I got one. I could take care of it. It was only $53 on eBay. I knew you didn't really want to get rid of yours, I could tell. It's like crystal clear. I know. It's all, like when I first saw it, I was like, ooh, you could see a lot. I don't know if I like it, but I like it. So let me get ready for Mad Gab. It's going to take me a little while to get it all set up. Maybe grab a snack or just take a little break. And then I will be back for a game of Mad Gab. And this scope was about, let's see, hour and 37 minutes. So I have another hour and 23 minutes left. We may or may not play Mad. Yeah, let's just do a full hour and a half long Mad Gab. And we'll call it a day. There won't be any whispering today. Sorry, y'all. But if you want to contact me, yes, we should grab a beer. Katie, I like the way you think. And thank you for the super hearts, girl. You're awesome. I appreciate you. I will grab a beer. I actually went and bought beer today because I drank the last beer last night for my gold badge celebration. And I will come back. We'll do an hour and a half of Mad Gab. It'll be a good time. And then we'll be done probably just a little bit after midnight. You're in via two places. Whoa, it's like Scopeception right now. Yes, so if you want to reach out to me, femyoga.com, you can let me know if you're like, you know, I don't want you to, maybe I'll ask Cyanide what she thinks, because she absolutely loves Mad Gab and she's addicted to ASMR. So she's been begging for both of these scopes, so I'm going to leave it up to her and see kind of what she says, because she is one of our platinum plus gold level sponsors. So she has a lot of say in what goes on the channel. If I think of all my platinum level sponsors, most of them like ASMR, but at least two of them really like Mad Gab too. So I'll have to figure out what we're going to do. But I'll definitely come back for a little bit of Mad Gab, maybe a little bit of whispering, or a lot of bit of Mad Gab. Sound good? Phone is way less lagged. Weird. ASMR helps me sleep. Yes, yeah, Steve, I just did one last night if you want to watch replays. Channel 1, channel 2. Ah, this is fun. Okay, I'm going to go now. I'm going to end this, and I'm going to be back in a little while for Mad Gab. See you soon. Remember that you're all worthy of being loved and feeling comfortable in your own skin. This has been another Moment in Time with Taylor. If you like this content, if you found $5 or more of value, I ask that you please go support this channel at femyoga.com. It is 100% viewer funded. Logitech didn't fund this. Eggdrop didn't fund this. Nobody funded this. I'm doing this just out of interest for you to know what I'm doing so that it doesn't seem so intimidating to you, because tech can be intimidating, but it's really, it doesn't need to be. All right? So I hope to see you very, very soon. This has been